Welcome, everybody, to this edition of Attention Dog Video. I'm your host, ADHD and Attention Coach, Jeff Copper. And today, I'm here to talk to you about an insight with regard to organization and working memory, and really just to understand your mind and how it works. I've done a lot of videos on working memory. Working memory has two parts. One is nonverbal working memory, which is basically self-talk. For many people with ADHD, it's easier if they talk out loud as opposed to think to yourself. Those are for other videos. Today, I'm here to key in on visual imagery. Visual imagery is the ability to create a picture in your mind or a diagram or relationships. Basically, it's putting things together. And your working memory is one of those things that's not long-term memory. It's the manipulation of information. So years ago, I was coaching an individual who hired a professional organizer. The organizer kind of came in and did some stuff, and I was coaching him shortly thereafter, and the guy was talking about how he couldn't find anything, which is a whole nother story. But the part of the story that I want to key in on is we had a conversation that he had a bunch of binders on a bookshelf, and they were like invisible to him. And in the conversation, he began to realize that one of the binders was for his bank statements. It was Bank of America. When he looked at the binder in Bank of America, what he began to realize is that when he had to read Bank of America, he would read the words and he would stop, almost close his eyes, and try to get an image of the bank in order to associate that. Well, that's effortful, having to read those words and assemble a picture in his mind. And so he would escape. What we did is we basically went online, searched for the Bank of America logo, printed it off, and put that on the outside of the binder. The association with the symbol eliminated the need for him to assemble the picture on his mind. And because there was less work, it was easier for him to find what he was looking for. In our digital world today, I think this can help us understand a lot. So I'm going to insert a picture here of my bookcase in my office. You can see a bunch of books. One in particular is a book called Spark by John Rady. Because of my exercise background, and the book is on exercise, it's a favorite. When I look at the bookshelf, the book has, it's yellow with red wording on the outside that says Spark. When I look at the bookcase and I look at the books, it's relatively easy for me to pick out that book on the shelf. I'm going to contrast that with just a screenshot of my Windows Explorer on my computer. What I have is a bunch of file folders, and under them are subfolders, and under them are subfolders, and under them are subfolders. And if you'll notice, is I have to read the words and I have to begin to think, where would my notes on that book Spark be located? Or if I had a digital copy, where would it be? And I keep having to use my visual imagery to imagine and think through what's going on, whereas I just walk over to my bookshelf, I can see it right there. What I want to glean from this is that if you have ADHD, particularly if you're very visual, having things out with visual imagery and associations of symbols makes it a lot easier sometimes for you to find things, whereas if you go onto your computer, you have to stop and think and picture your way through the process. That's effortful. It's hard for many people with ADHD, and that's why you escape. So the idea here really is if you're somebody who has a lot of books and they're out and you're very visual, I want you to feel validated. That's why you feel the urge to do that, and it's a very effective strategy for you. If you're somebody who succumbed to the digital age and you feel the urge to have the books on the shelf as opposed to on your hard drive, I want to appeal to you. Maybe you should put them back on the bookshelf because it's a lot easier for you. It's creating a lot of anxiety, the invisibility of it all. The other side of it is if you do have it digital, it presents a little bit of a challenge. I've actually had people before where we had maps, visual maps, where they would diagram stuff on the wall so they can picture it and would kind of like, oh, there's the picture where that would be, and they work their way back. Mind you, that's a lot of work. It's a lot of work to kind of put that stuff together. Other people have like indexes where they'll put words and stuff that they can search to try to find it. And some of you don't have trouble with this at all. You just can remember where things are and type the name into the search part. Anyway, the bottom line with this is I really wanted to highlight this is how the challenge of working memory manifests for people with ADHD. And when you start talking about tips, tricks, and strategies, and you start getting on the computer and it's taxing to your working memory, you can begin to see why anything you come up with can be difficult because your working memories get in the way. At the end of the day, I hope this is helping you guys understand some of the root cause and will enable you to problem solve a little bit and or relieve some of the emotion and the anxiety to understand why you have books on shelves and you have things out so you can visually see. I hope this gave you a little bit of insight. Please subscribe to our channel if you're not a member. We release a video like this every week. And also, interested in your comments. What do you guys think of this? Do you identify with it? Does it explain what's going on? Or do you have an alternative theory? Please leave your comments. It's always helpful for me. I hope you've enjoyed us. Catch us next week for another great edition of Attention Dog Video. Take care.